What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you hit that like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, we'll be continuing with the rendering, the next rendering type. Last video, we were talking about the multiband color. This video, we'll be talking about the paletted and the unique values. So let's go ahead and jump into the properties of one of these raster layers. So let's go ahead and double click here. Here's our properties, and let's go ahead and jump into the symbology. Flip over to paletted with unique values. Okay, so now what does this even mean? What is this going to allow us to do? First of all, it's going to only allow you to manipulate one band at a time. So you need to choose the band that you're going to work within. And by choosing or by knowing the band, you will know the minimum and the maximum for that band that you can work with. So for this particular band, I'll use band 1. And what I want to do is I want to set a specific color for a specific pixel with a specific value, okay? Or I say a specific pixel for all of the pixels with a specific value. So let's go ahead and do this. So there are several buttons down here. We have the classify button, the plus or minus, and then we have the delete all button. Now in the last video, I went over these functions down here, color rendering and resampling. So if you didn't see that, go back to the last video. But we're going to stay up here and manipulate some colors and some images in here. So let's say that I want to highlight all of the pixels that are near the standard mean or the statistical mean of this specific image. So I want to find the standard mean. So if I go to the information tab here and I look within what band that I had, the statistical mean was 121.22, whatever that is. So let's go ahead and copy that. And I just press Control C if you're on a Windows computer. Go back to symbology, and we're going to add that value. So over here, we'll double click right here in the value. We can double click or we can just right click on here and we can change whatever we want to change. But to change the value, you'll need to double click on it and I'll paste that number. Okay, there's our number. And I want all of those to be, let's go into our select color. In this select color dialog box, if you've never been in here, there's several different user interfaces, just easy ways to select your colors and manipulate the different changes of the colors, okay? Also, if you want to know the exact notation of your color, it's right here. You can actually change the format of this, whether you want the red, green, or blue. You want the red, you want these different formats, basically. You can change through those. Okay, so let's just pick a color. I guess it could be greenish. Actually, I'll just make it that color. I like this right here. All right, and then what else? We have these other ones that we could use here. They're not as dynamic as the first one. And this last one is just a sample. So you can actually sample any color pretty much on your screen, on your visible computer screen. So if I hit sample color and I scroll over anything, it's going to allow me to see the color of that specific thing, okay? So whatever color that I like, let's say if I like this blue right here, or I like this yellow right here, I can barely get onto it. Any of these colors, all I need to do is get over it, click, and it's locked in right there. And we can add it to our presets. And it goes to the first preset. Let's say if I wanted some custom colors, I want my own palette of custom colors. Well, if I hit this down button here, I can actually hit new palette, or if I already have a palette, I can import a palette that I've already created. But in this case, I'll hit new palette, create something called my colors. and it'll be a new palette, and I put this color in there. So all you need to do is drag and drop. Drag and drop, and that's my color now. Okay, but anyway, that just went off on a tangent. We can press OK. And that's our color, and all of the values that are 121 that are that mean will be showing over here. Well, I say all of the values, all of the pixels with that value will be showing. So we'll hit apply. Hit apply. And there are very few outside of that range that I can see. I don't see any right now. All right, let's be more broad. Let's change this to be less exact. Let's go 121 here, and we'll hit apply. Okay, now you can kind of see, now in that 121 range, it's capturing more of those pixels that hold that value, okay? So these are the pixels that are holding those values. I can actually go out here and zoom in, because it's kind of hard to see. Alright, these are the pixels, and some of these pixels are really grouped together, like right in here. All of these are that 121 pixel value, okay? And you can actually be very dynamic with the way that your picture looks by setting the colors the way that you would like them to be set. Let's go back to the properties here, or actually let me zoom out first. Zoom out, we'll zoom out right here. Move that over a little bit. I want the hand right there. Okay, move that back over right there. And let's go ahead and go back into our properties. And we have our 121. Let's say that we wanted to also know the standard deviation out here. So I want to know the pretty much what is the first deviation away from this value. Well, if we go back to the information tab, we'll see right here the statistical standard deviation is 29, almost 30 digits away from our mean. So let's make a color for that. So 21, we can just round it off and say that'll be what, 60 or 55, something somewhere up in there. We'll just say 155 for that color. So we'll create another color. This will be a deviation outside of that range at the 155. That's one standard deviation out. We can change the label if we want to 155. And then we'll hit apply for that color. Now it's put all of those values out there that are one standard deviation away. What if we wanted to go two standard deviations away? All we would need to do is multiply this number, or multiply by whatever that. So the first standard deviation is 29. If we wanted to go two out, we would just multiply this by two, and that would be two outside of the standard deviation of that particular mean value. All right. Now that we've covered that little part, now let's get into the more interesting part of this. So we'll go ahead and delete this. We'll delete those. And there is a option here that is the color ramp. Okay, and right now it is set to random colors, and you can actually hit this classify button and it will classify everything by random colors, but we want to be more specific. Okay, so we'll come down, we'll hit this drop down, and there are several different color ramps that you can use here. These are the presets. You can shuffle random colors, you can bring up all of the color ramps that you can use, but let's do something more interesting. Let's create our own color ramps. So we're going to go into this create new color ramp, and there are several options in here. This is the first option, which is gradient. We'll hit OK, and let's go ahead and make a color gradient for a specific range of colors. So let's say I want to go from, we can just use these colors that have popped in here. And there are two different types that you can use. Those two types are continuous and discrete. Now, if you use discrete, it's almost as if you're saying or. It's like an or function. You want this or that, but not both. Okay? So in the continuous, we can see how it meshes meshes into the next color. But in the discrete, we see that it is a almost like an OR function. We want it to be this, we want our values to be this or that, okay? We'll keep it on the continuous, but I was just showing you that. A couple more things in this dialog box. There's a lot of manipulation you can do in here. You can actually scroll down a little bit and you can see the plot patterns of these colors. And you can add opacity, you can add lightness, you can add saturation, or you can add hue. So if I start to, let's say if I add all four of these, right? Saturation, hue, everything is there now. All right, so let's go ahead and manipulate these. We can move these along these scales, and you'll see these. This is basically a visual another visual representation of what's going on here. All right, so I can add, this is the hue right here. If I delete this hue, add it back. Now, this is the hue, okay. This is the hue right here. And as I manipulate it, you see things change dramatically there. So let's say if we get rid of the hue, but we want saturation. Saturation here, and the more saturated something is, the deeper the color. So if it's a blue, it's going to be a deep blue. It's not going to be a faded blue, and that's what saturation does. Then you have the lightness, and then the opacity, pretty much the transparency. The lightness is just basically the brightness of the color. But anyway, that's just stepping on into a little bit of color manipulation here. We'll hit okay. And this is the range that we want to be within. Now, let's just press classify. If we press classify here, what it's going to do is take the minimum value here all the way to the maximum value of this range and classify all of them by these colors. So we'll hit classify, and it may take a little bit, so I may have to fast forward a little bit. So here we go. All right, so it has finished classifying, and now what it has done is went from zero, our lower range on our color ramp, and if we scroll down, guess what? As we scroll, we see that change from zero to 255. So let's go ahead and hit apply. And now look at our color map there. All right, so this was our bottom color, or our darker ranges, which is the zero, and then our lighter ranges, which is near the 255 there. So that's a little bit of color manipulation there. Let's continue on. If we hit this drop down button again and we create a new color ramp again, let's go ahead and hit the pull down and hit the color presets, hit okay. Here you can actually preset specific colors that will be used almost like the discrete function. So if I add a color here, let's just add my color right there, and we hit okay there. Well, I want to add another one as well. Let's just add this one, and we'll hit okay there. So these are three discrete color presets that are going to be used. We'll press okay, and these three from zero to 255, these will be used to make our colors. Now, I'm not gonna keep hitting classify because it takes a while for the algorithm to run. So I'll go ahead and run through the rest of the things I wanna show you. We can continue here with the creation. We can create random ramps. And so we can decide, hey, what kind of hue do we want to work in? Do we want colors that are lighter or darker? Do we want the saturation to be more or less? Do we want the values here? Like, let's say if I change this to zero and this one to 255, which is our top range, it'll go from the darkest to the lightest randomly. Okay, and we can also change the classes, how many classes we have here. And but these will be random. All that you decide with these colors are the hue, the saturation, how the deepness of the color, the values, whether you want to cut a little bit off or you want to give it the full range between 0 and 255, and then the classes. All right, let's continue. I'm gonna move through this a little bit faster. Create new color ramp. We'll go here to catalog CPT City. This one is a great tool here. It has so many colors you can use here. All these color ramps. And did I just move that or something? I want to move it over. Let's see. Anyway, all these color ramps here. Oh, I'm wondering, why did it move this over? There we go. Man, couldn't grip that for anything. Okay, so all of these different color patterns here, I guess some of them do that and some of them don't. All of these different color patterns you can come in here and use. You can see the license of when they're made and who they're made by, what year. You can also go to the information and see the exact author that has made this specific color pattern. So you can give them any kind of attribution that you want to give them. If you like a specific author, you can go to all by author and you can look down through the initials here. So let's see if we go to CB. We go to information, we'll see that this is Cynthia Brewer and Mark Howerer. Okay, so these are all by these specific authors. Anyway, you can save these upon your exit as a specific color. So if I was to click this brown, blue, green, looks like we could save that as a color gradient for us when we exit. So if I hit okay, and then if I pull this down, it should be in here somewhere, but we'll have to find it. Edit color ramp, save color ramp. We can do any of these where you can save it to a specific place, give it a name, tags, and then you can add it to your favorites. But anyway, let's continue on. There are a couple more. I'm trying to make this quick. All right, Color Brewer. Color Brewer, we can actually set up a scheme name. There are different names here. Red, yellow, green, set two. You can find whatever you like, and then you can decide whether the colors will be broken down into three classifications or nine different classifications, from the lighter to the darker. Okay, and so those are a lot of the color manipulation that you can do with these ranges. And all you need to do from here is just hit classify, and it classified this one quick, so it just did that right there. And if we hit apply down here, we'll see the color change over here. There's our color change. But that's all I wanted to talk about in this video with the palette and the unique values. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.